हेलो स्टूडेंट, वेलकम टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल। इन दिस वीडियो मैग्नेटिज्म एंड मैटर वी विल डिस्कस द टॉपिक बार मैग्नेट इन यूनिफॉर्म मैग्नेटिक फील्ड, बार मैग्नेट एज एन इक्विवेलेंट सोलेनोइड, एंड वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट अर्थ मैग्नेटिज्म एंड इट्स प्रॉपर्टीज। क्लियर? सो लेट स्टार्ट विद टॉपिक बार मैग्नेट एज एन इक्विवेलेंट सोलेनोइड। So we know that a current carrying loop acts as a magnetic dipole. We have discussed about this in previous video. So according to Ampere's hypothesis, all magnetic phenomena can be explained in terms of circulating current. Clear? So in figure you see that this is a solenoid. Its magnetic field lines are, this is south pole and this is north pole. And if we talk about bar magnet, a magnetic field lines are bar magnets, looks like this. From above two figures, we see that magnetic field lines for a bar magnet and a current carrying solenoid resembles very closely. Therefore, a bar magnet can be thought of a large number of circulating current carrying solenoid. I hope this is clear to you. Cutting a bar magnet is like cutting a solenoid. We get two smaller solenoid with weaker magnetic property. The magnetic field lines remains continuous, emerging from one phase of one solenoid and entering into the other phase of the other solenoid. So if we were to move a small compass needle in the neighborhood of a bar magnet, the current carrying coil solenoid, we would find that reflection of the needles are similar in both these two cases. So let demonstrate the similarity of current carrying solenoid of a bar magnet. Let us calculate the magnetic field line at the axial point of a finite current carrying solenoid. So in this figure we have a current carrying solenoid. Current I is flowing through this solenoid. Radius of the solenoid is A, length of the solenoid is 2L, and N is the number of turns per unit length. Okay, here N is the number of turns per unit length of the solenoid. So we have to calculate magnetic field at a point P, which is at a distance R from O. Okay? Consider a small element of thickness dx at a distance x from this point O. Clear? So the magnetic field at point P due to this current carrying element is given by B equal to, can write B equal to mu naught N I A square into dx, N I A square into dx upon 2 R minus X square plus A square raised to power 3/2. Clear? Here N D is the number of turns in a circular element, and R minus X is the distance of a point from the center of this element. Clear? If point P is at a very large distance from O, that is R is much greater than R is much greater than A, we can write R is much greater than A, or we can say R is much greater than X. So from our equation we will get dB equal to is given by mu naught I A square and dx upon 2 R cube. Clear? So now, magnetic field at point P due to the entire current carrying solenoid is given by integrate above equation. So we will get B equal to mu naught N I A square upon 2R cube integral minus L to L into dx. On integrating this, we will get B equal to mu naught N I A
square upon 2r cube into 2l, right? So we know that nia is magnitude of a magnetic dipole moment. So here this is n into 2l. N into 2l is number of turns, total number of turns in a solenoid. N into 2l, we can write n into 2l is n. So we can write this equation, n into 2l equal to n equal to n into 2l, total number of turns in a solenoid. And pi a square equal to capital A. Is the pi a square is the area of the cross sections. So from our equation we will get b equal to given by mu naught over 4 pi 2 nia mu naught over 4 pi into 2 nia upon r cube, 2 nia upon r cube, right? Nia capital A area upon r cube. So here nia is the magnitude of a magnetic dipole moment. Nia equal to capital M. So we can write in this equation mu naught over 4 pi into 2 m upon r cube. Here so above relation also gives us the magnetic field at point P due to a bar magnet. So thus we can say that a magnetic field produced by a bar magnet and the solenoids are similar. So I hope this is clear to you. Now torque on a magnetic dipole in a uniform magnetic field. So in figure we see that these are magnetic field lines. Consider a magnet, bar magnet is placed in this magnetic field making angle theta with the direction of magnetic field. M is the magnetic field strength here, N is north pole and S is south pole. The distance between pole is 2L. So the force of magnitude dB acts opposite to each other. Force on due to north pole is MB, force on south pole is MB. These two forces of a magnitude MB acts opposite to each other, and hence net force acting on the bar magnet due to the external uniform magnetic field is zero. Clear? So this magnet does not have any linear motion. Okay? There is no translational motion of a magnet. Clear? However, the forces along different line of action, these two forces acting along the different line of action, so they have a couple. Due to this couple, they experience a torque. Due to this torque, this coil, this magnet start rotating. Clear? So we have torque is given by magnetic force into perpendicular distance. So magnetic force is MB, a perpendicular distance between these two forces given by, from this figure B is in this direction and magnet is in this direction. Angle between magnet and field is theta. The perpendicular distance is given by 2L sine theta. Here M, this is the perpendicular distance, which is given by 2L sine theta. So from this equation, we will get MB sine theta. So torque is a vector quantity. So in vector form, we can write torque equal to M cross B. Direction of this torque is perpendicular and into the plane containing M and B. So I hope this is clear to you. Now next is work done on a magnetic dipole in a uniform magnetic field. If we place a magnetic dipole or magnetic bar magnet in a uniform magnetic field, what work it does? So let's start this. These are magnetic field line as shown in the figure. Bar magnet is magnetic field making angle theta 1. MB is the force acting on this magnet. Clear? If this coil, this magnet rotate from angle theta 1 to theta 2, it is given by, this is magnet in a uniform magnetic field. Clear? Initially, it make angle theta 1. Theta 1 is given by from this equation. Uniform magnetic field, bar magnet is placed in this uniform magnetic field. Theta 1 is the angle, initial angle. After time t, after any, at any time, it rotates from theta 1 to theta t, theta 2. It's shown in figure. Clear? So the work done at any time rotating this bar magnet from angle d theta is given by dw equal to torque into d theta. Clear? When a magnet of dipole moment M is held in a, at an angle theta 1 with the direction of uniform magnetic field, the magnitude of the torque is given by torque equal to mv sine theta. So we can write t equal to mv sine theta into d theta. This torque tend to align the dipole in the direction of field, so work has to be done in rotating this dipole against the action of the magnetic field. Clear? So this work done is stored in the magnetic dipole as potential energy. Clear? So total work done rotating the dipole from angle theta 1 to theta 2 is given by mb sine theta d theta. Integrating this theta 1 to theta 2 mb sine theta into d theta. On integrating this, we will get work done equal to mb cos theta 1 minus cos theta 2. Here we know the value of integration of sine theta. Integration of sine theta is minus cos theta. Here integration of sine theta is minus cos theta. Okay, on applying limit theta 1 to theta 2, we will get this equation. So I hope this is clear to you. Work done equal to mb cos theta 1 minus cos theta 2. So if potential energy is arbitrarily taking 0 when the dipole is at 90 degree, then potential energy rotating dipole and including it at an angle theta is given by potential energy equal to minus mb cos theta. Potential energy is minus mv cos theta. Note, potential energy can be taken zero arbitrarily at any position of the dipole. Clear? Let's talk about Earth's magnetic field. I hope these two derivations are clear to you. Clear? So let's start Earth magnetism. What is Earth magnetism and cause of Earth magnetism? We therefore conclude that geographic north pole of Earth correspond to a magnetic south pole and the geographic south pole of the Earth correspond to a magnetic north pole. Okay. William Gilbert was the first who suggests that the Earth itself a huge magnet. His statement was based on the following evidence. Evidence are a magnet suspended from a thread and free to rotate in horizontal plane comes to rest along a north-south direction. On disturbing the magnet, it returns quickly to its north-south direction. Again, this is as use bar magnet is placed approximately along the axis of rotation of the earth and deep in the interior. The north pole of this fictitious magnet must be towards geographic north or attract south pole of the suspended magnet. We must add here that magnet is just as a conceptual device adopted to explain the earth magnetic field. Clear? In reality, there is no such bar magnet in the interior of the earth. Second conclusion is When a soft iron piece is buried under the surface of the earth in the north-south direction, it is found that this soft iron acquires the property of magnet after some time. And when we draw field lines of magnet, we come across neutral point. At these points, magnetic field due to the magnet is neutralized or cancelled exactly by the magnetic field of Earth. If Earth had no magnetism of its own, we would never observe neutral points. So about neutral point, we will discuss later. Clear? Now, cause of Earth magnetism. According to Professor Brackett, Earth magnetism may be due to the rotation of Earth about its axis. This is because every substance is made up of a charged particle, proton or electron. Therefore, a substance rotating about an axis equivalent to circulating current, which is responsible for this magnetization. So, according to Professor Brackett, the evidence of cause of Earth magnetism is rotation of Earth. Clear? In outer layer of Earth's atmosphere, gases are in ionized state. Primarily on account of cosmic rays, as the Earth rotates, strong electric currents are set up in movement of the charged ion. And these currents might be magnetized on the Earth. Clear? And next is cause of Earth magnetism is the Earth's core is extremely hot and molten. So circulatory ion of irons and nickel in the highly conducting liquid region of Earth's core might be forming current loop and produce Earth magnetism. Clear? So this hypothesis is supported by the following fact that Moon has no molten core and it has no magnetic field. Venus has a slower rate of rotation and it has a weaker magnetic field. And Jupiter has the fastest rotation rate. So it has a fairly strong magnetic field. Clear? So in this figure, these are magnetic lines. This is the rotation of Earth. This is the axis of rotation, which is called geographic axis. These are magnetic field lines of the magnet. The magnetic field pattern of the Earth is similar to the pattern of the bar magnet. As you can see in this figure, this is the bar magnet, this is the Earth. So you see that magnetic field pattern of Earth is similar to the magnetic field pattern of the bar magnet placed at its center. So an interesting fact concerning Earth's magnetic field is that its direction reverses every few million years. Okay? So these are terrestrialism, the branch of physics which deals with the study of magnetism of Earth is called terrestrial magnetism or geomagnetism. Here the value strength of the Earth's magnetism is 10^-5 Tesla. Okay? Geographic axis. What is geographic axis? Geographic axis is the axis of rotation of the Earth is called geographic axis. As I told you in previous slide, axis of rotation of the Earth is called geographic axis. And the point where it cuts the Earth's surface are called its geographic pole. That is North Pole or South Pole. Clear? So the geographic axis is a straight line passing through the geographical poles of the Earth. It is the axis of rotation of the Earth. It is also known as polar axis. Geographic meridian is an imaginary vertical plane passing through geographic axis of Earth is called geographic meridian. So geographic meridian is any place in a vertical plane passing through geographic north pole and geographic south pole. Geographic equator is a circle on a surface of the Earth in a plane perpendicular to the geographic axis. Clear? In this figure, we can say this is the Earth. This is axis of the rotation of Earth. This is geographic North Pole. This is geographic South Pole. This is the geographic axis. Clear? And this is magnetic axis. This is magnetic South Pole. This is magnetic North Pole. This is equator of the Earth. This is geographic equator. And this is, we can say, this is magnetic equator. I hope this is clear to you from this diagram. So geographic equator is a circle on the surface of the Earth in a plane perpendicular to geographic axis. All the points on the geographic equator are at equal distance from the geographic poles. And magnetic axis is a straight line passing through the magnetic poles of Earth. It is inclined to geographic axis nearly at an angle of 17 degrees. Magnetic meridian is a place in a vertical plane passing through the magnetic north and magnetic south. Clear? Magnetic meridian is the place in a vertical plane passing through the magnetic north and magnetic south. So I hope this is clear to you. What is magnetic meridian or what is geographic meridian? Clear? Magnetic equator is a great circle on the surface of the Earth in a plane perpendicular to the magnetic axis. All the points on the magnetic equator are at equal distance from the magnetic pole. Clear? So these are some points of Earth magnetism: geographic axis, geographic meridian, geographic equator, magnetic axis, magnetic meridian, and magnetic equator. Clear? If we see in this diagram, this is Earth. This is axis of rotation of Earth. We can say this is a geographic axis. This is geographic north, and this is geographic south pole. This is magnetic south pole. This is magnetic north pole. Clear? This is geographic equator, or this is magnetic equator. So I hope these points are clear to you. Clear? Meridian is the magnetic meridian and geographic meridian. Magnetic meridian is a place in vertical plane passing through the magnetic north and magnetic south of the Earth. And geographic meridian is a place in a vertical plane passing through the geographic North Pole and geographic South Pole. Clear? Now, what is angle of declination, magnetic declination, magnetic inclination, or horizontal components? So this is geographic meridian and this is magnetic meridian. Clear? The angle between geographic meridian and magnetic meridian is called angle of declination. Declination is angle between magnetic meridian and the geographic meridian at a place in declination at that place is angle of declination. It varies from place to place. Here, what is magnetic declination? Magnetic declination is when a bar magnet is suspended freely. This is a bar magnet. Here, this is North Pole and this is South Pole. And this is geographic axis of the Earth. So, if a bar magnet is suspended freely by a silk thread, this is suspended freely. By a silk thread, the ends of a magnet do not point out exactly along geographic north-south direction as shown in this figure. The line joining the north and south pole of freely suspended magnet is called magnetic axis, and the axis about which Earth rotates is called geographic axis, as I told you. the small angle between magnetic axis and the geographic axis. This is magnetic axis and geographic axis is called magnetic declination at that place, and it is denoted by theta. Clear? And a vertical plane passing through north south line of a freely suspended magnet is called magnetic meridian, and vertical plane passing through the geographic north south direction is called geographic meridian, as shown in this figure. So we may therefore also define magnetic declination at a place as the angle between magnetic meridian and geographic meridian at that place. Clear? So I hope this point is clear to you. What is magnetic declination? The line joining, the lines shown on the map through the place that have a same declination are called isogonic lines, which have the same declination is called isogonic. And the line drawn through place that have zero declination is called isogonic lines which have a same declination, and agonic line which have a zero declination. I hope these two points are clear to you. Now what is dip or inclination? What is magnetic inclination, or we can say magnetic dip? So from figure, we see that in this figure, we can say this is a, just name this figure A, B, C, D, E, or A, this one or this one is K. Okay, so from figure A, this is magnetic meridian, D, E, and A, D, D, E, B, C is magnetic meridian, and D, A, B, C is magnetic meridian, and DEBC is geographic meridian. Clear? So from above this figure, we see that this is the angle between magnetic meridian and geographic meridian is theta. This is total magnetic field, and this is the horizontal component of magnetic field. Clear? From this figure, we see that B is the total magnetic field. It has two components. One component is horizontal component, and other one is BB is vertical component of the magnetic field. Clear? So magnetic declination arises because the axis of bar magnet responsible for Earth's magnetism does not coincide with the axis of rotation of the Earth. Okay? So the imaginary magnetic lies at an angle of about 11.3 degree west of the polar axis. So the Earth's magnet poles are not at directly opposite position of globe. Current magnetic south is farther from geographic south than magnetic north is from geographic north. Clear? So the what is magnetic inclination? It is the angle between the horizontal component of Earth magnetism. So where is the horizontal component of Earth magnetism? This is horizontal component of Earth magnetism and total magnetic field. The angle between horizontal component of Earth magnetic field and the Earth's resultant magnetic field at a place is called dip or inclination at that place. So I hope this is clear to you. What is magnetic declination? Magnetic inclination is the angle between horizontal component of Earth magnetic field and the Earth resultant magnetic field at a place is dip or inclination at that place. Magnetic inclination is zero at equator and it is 90 degree at the pole. So line drawn on a map through places that have a same dip are called isoclinic lines. and the line drawn through places that have a zero dip is all is known as acyclic line. It is the magnetic equator. Clear? So horizontal component of Earth magnetic field. So from above figure, from above diagram, we see that BH equal to B cos delta and BB equal to B sin theta. Clear? BH is the horizontal component and BB equal to vertical component, B sin theta. The total intensity of Earth magnetic field does not lie in any horizontal plane. Instead, it lies along the direction at an angle of dip to the horizontal. So the component of Earth magnetic field among the horizontal at an angle delta is called horizontal component of Earth magnetic field, which is given by BH equal to B cos delta. And similarly, vertical component is BV equal to B sin delta. So on squaring and adding these two equations, we will get B square H plus B square V equal to B square cos square delta plus sin square delta. So we will get B equal to under root B square H plus B square Y. Clear? I hope this is clear to you. BH equals to B cos delta, BV equal to B sin delta. So on squaring and adding this equation, we will get B equal to root B square H plus B square V. Now tangent law. What is the tangent law? So this is the magnetic needle. It moves from in this direction. Theta is the angle B1 and B. If the needle is suspended in a region where two uniform magnetic fields are perpendicular to each other. So from in this figure, we see that B1 and B2 are two magnetic fields which are perpendicular to each other. The needle will align itself along the direction of the resultant field of the two fields at an angle theta, such that the tangent of the angle is the ratio of the two fields is tan theta equal to B1 upon B2. I hope this is clear to you. Tangent law. What is tangent law? According to this law, the magnetic needle will align itself along a direction of the resultant field of the two fields at an angle theta, such that the tangent of the angle is the ratio of the two fields, that is tan theta is equal to B1 upon B2. Clear? Tan theta is B1 upon B2. Let's talk about neutral point. When we trace a magnetic field lines of force around a magnet using a compass needle, what we obtain is the resultant of magnetic field of magnet and that of the magnet. As Earth field is fixed, the resultant field would depend on the direction in which the magnet is placed. Clear? So, as Earth field is fixed, the resultant field bound depend on the direction in which the magnet is placed. In plot of resultant field, we come across a point at which field due to a magnet become equal and opposite to the horizontal component of Earth field. So therefore, the net magnetic field at this point is zero. So this point where magnetic field is zero is called neutral point. Clear? This point where magnetic field due to magnet and magnetic field of Earth is zero are called neutral point. In this field, if we place a compass needle, it does not show any deflection. It means it does not experience any torque or no force. So it can set itself in any direction, which may be different from the usual north-south direction. So I hope this is clear to you what is neutral point.
So when a bar magnet is placed with its north pole pointing to geographic south pole. So if we draw a diagram, in this we see that this is the magnet, this is north pole and this is south pole. This is geographic north pole and this is geographic south pole. If we draw magnetic field lines, we know that magnetic field lines from north to south. So from this magnet it will be right, and we know that magnetic field lines is from north pole to south pole. So from north pole it is in outward, and from for south pole it is inward. If we draw magnetic field line, we see that it looks like this. Clear? Magnetic field lines will be like this. So in this condition, neutral point will be at this point. When a bar magnet on a paper sheet fixed on a drawing board such that its north pole points towards the geographic north pole and south pole points towards the geographic south pole. Now trace the magnetic field line using compass needle. The pattern of the resultant magnetic field due to the bar magnet and horizontal component earth magnet is shown in this figure. So we see that we see two neutral points. This is neutral point N1 or this is neutral point N2. Clear? These two points are located on the equatorial line of the magnet and are equidistant from the center of the bar magnet. At this point, the magnetic field due to the bar magnet is equal and opposite to the horizontal component of the Earth's magnetic field. So they cancel each other. Clear? So at neutral point, magnetic field equal to BM equal to BH. I hope this is clear to you. BM equal to BH, which is given by, we can write M equal to BH 4 pi x square plus L square root raised to power 3 by 2 upon mu naught. Clear? When a bar magnet is placed with its north pole pointing to the geographic south pole. So in this case is opposite to the above case. This is south pole and this is north pole. This is geographic north pole and this is geographic south pole. Now draw a magnetic field line. So this is something like this. North to south, north to south. For earth magnetism, we see that magnetic field lines would be inside this. For this, magnetic field lines will be clear. From this, we see that direction of magnetic field lines will be from here, direction of magnetic field lines will be in this inside, in this direction, opposite to this magnetic field. Clear? North to south, it is in this direction and it will be in this direction. So I hope this is clear to you. Clear? So if we place a bar magnet with its north pole pointing to the geographic south pole and south pole pointing to the geographic north pole, the magnetic field lines look like this. Clear? The pattern of the resultant magnetic field due to the bar magnet and the horizontal component of the magnetic field is as shown in this figure. So from figure we see that magnetic field lines magnetic field line cancel the magnetic field due to the earth. So we have two neutral points N1 and N2. Lie on the axial line and are equidistant from the center of the earth. Clear? So these are neutral points. Neutral point is the point at which the magnetic field due to bar magnet
is neutralized by the horizontal component of the earth magnetic field. If we place a bar magnet with its north pole pointing to the geographic north pole and south pole pointing to the geographic south pole, the neutral point is found at the equatorial line. And if we place a bar magnet with its north pole pointing to geographic south pole and south pole pointing to geographic north pole, we find the neutral point at the axial lines. Clear? So this was something about neutral point. Let's start to solve some problem. Magnetic needle free to rotate in a vertical plane parallel to the magnetic meridian has its north depth pointing down at 22 degree with the horizontal. The horizontal component of earth magnetic field at a place is known to be 0.3 gauss. So to determine the strength of the magnetic field, in this question you have to determine the strength of the magnetic field. So for this, how will you find the strength of the magnetic field? Here angle of dip is 22 degree and this is 0.35 gauss is the earth magnetic field. Clear? Horizontal component is 0.35 gauss. For this, horizontal component is, we know that at horizontal component is given by BE cos delta. Cos delta is given 22 degree. We know that cos 22 degree is 0.9272. So put the value in this formula and find the value of earth magnetic field at this place. Second question is, where on the earth surface the value of vertical component of magnetic field is zero? Clear? The horizontal component of earth magnetic field at a given place is 0.4 × 10⁻⁴ Wb per meter square and angle of dip is 30 degree. Calculate the value of vertical component, total intensity of magnetic field. So for this, first question, you have to find the point vertical component of earth. You have to find the where on the earth surface the vertical component of the magnetic field is zero. And how to solve these questions? You will solve this question by the formula 10 delta is given by V upon S. We know the value of horizontal component. Horizontal component VS is given by B cos theta and BV is given by B sine theta. Okay. So on dividing this equation by this equation, we will get 10 theta equal to BV upon BS. BV is vertical component, or BS is horizontal component. So you will get the value of delta. Clear? Now from horizontal component, you will get the value of BE, total intensity of magnetic field B. Clear? So next question is, in a magnetic meridian of the certain place, the horizontal component of earth magnetic field is 0.26 gauss and the angle of dip is 60 degree. What is the magnetic field of earth at this location? Magnetic field of the earth at this location. So apply the horizontal component of the magnetic field formula and you will get the answer. And you can also find the vertical component. Vertical component is given by V equal to BB sine theta. B sine theta is vertical component. So apply these two formulae and solve this question. In Bohr model of hydrogen atom, electron move around the nucleus in a circular orbit of radius 0.53 angstrom at a frequency of 6.8 × 10⁹ megahertz. Calculate the magnetic induction at the center of the orbit. What is the equivalent dipole moment? So solve this question by yourself. Next is a bar magnet of length 10 centimeter has a pole strength of 80 ampere into meter. Find the magnetic intensity due to the magnet at a point of axial line 20 centimeter from its center and 20 meter from its center. So you can solve this question by using equatorial and axial line formula. Bar magnet of magnetic moment G6 joule per tesla is aligned at 60 degree with the uniform magnetic field of 0.44 tesla. Calculate the work done in turning the magnet to align its magnetic moment normal to magnetic field and opposite to magnetic field. Apply work done formula in a uniform magnetic field and solve this question. Next is short bar magnet placed with its axis at 30 degree with a uniform external magnetic field of 0.16 tesla experience a torque of magnitude 0.032 joule. Estimate the magnetic moment of the dipole moment bar magnet, and if a bar magnet was free to rotate, which orientation would correspond to its stable and unstable? So solve this question using bar magnet in uniform magnetic field. Short bar magnet magnetic moment 0.5 joule per tesla placed with its axis at 30 degree with a uniform external magnetic field experience a torque. Calculate the strength of the magnetic field. So apply the formula of torque and find the value of magnetic field. Last question is a short bar magnet placed with its axis at 30 degree at external magnetic field experience a torque 0.016 newton into meter. Find out what is the magnetic moment of magnet. What is the work done in turning it from stable to unstable position? Initial potential energy of the magnet, work done in timing, turning it from its present position to its position of unstable equilibrium. Solve these questions by yourself. Keep watching and keep learning. Thank you.